And today I'm going to present our project, the matrix and probability analyzing the football tournaments. So there are many different kinds of football tournaments in different competitions, but we are wondering which of them have the better reliability and which of them can bring a better profit for the organizer. Besides, for FIFA World Cup, as we know that there are special arrangements for the last 32 teams, we want to discuss about that in our project. So in order to investigate these questions in a mathematical way, we define some tools for us to do so. Firstly, we define the strength of each team by their team numbers. The smaller the team number, the stronger the team, which means that team 1 will be the strongest among all the teams. Secondly, we define the probability matrix of the tournaments. The number of rows will be the team number, and the number of columns will be the rank in the competition. And the corresponding entries in the matrix will be the corresponding probability of that team getting the corresponding rank. Besides, we define the reliability R, which is the trace of the probability matrix, as we believe that a tournament will be more reliable if they reflect the true ranking, which means that team 1 will get a champion, etc. So here is an example for the probability matrix and the corresponding reliability value. So here the one in the top left corner means that the team 1 must get the champion in this competition. And the second row, the second column means that team 2 will have a 2/3 of chance getting the first runner-up in this competition. And for the reliability value, which is the sum of the diagonal values, it is 3 1/3 here, which is quite high as the reliability value should be maximum as 4. So after defining these tools, we are going to look at the application of them in different kinds of tournaments. To start with, it is the round robin tournament, which means that every teams will meet each other in the competition in turn. As a result, the probability matrix will be the identity matrix, as it must reflect the true ranking of them, and corresponding reliability value will fall as the identity matrix will be the probability matrix of this tournament. So next, which is the single elimination tournament. It is a type of tournament that the loser in each match will be knocked out immediately. A match is added for the loser in the semi-final in order to find out which of the team is the second runner-up and which of them will be the third runner-up. So in order to find out this probability matrix of the tournament, we use the idea of the multiplication of the matrix. The idea of this lemma is that after the first round of the tournament, the probability of team I getting the J-th place in the competition is equal to the sum of the product of team I getting the K-th place in the first round and the team ranked K getting the J-th place finally. It is exactly the same as the idea of the multiplication in matrix, and the required matrix shown here is found by some combinatorial skills. So by using the idea stated before, we are able to find out the general formula of the probability matrix of the single elimination tournament. And this can be proved by the mathematical induction just as what we have done in the project. So apart from the original form of the single elimination tournament, there is an improved version which is used in football competition frequently also. The participants are divided into small groups first, and the top two teams in the group will be able to join the second round of the competition. Inside the group, round-robin tournament will be used for choosing the top two teams, and the remaining step is just identical to the single elimination tournament. So in this case, the only concern will be the stage before the knockout part of the tournament. As for the knockout part of it, we can use the probability matrix found by the previous part. And after some calculation, we found out the required probability for using the multiplication of matrix. And hence, we can make up a general formula for the improved single elimination tournament as well. And in here, the n representing there are 2^n teams in the throughout all the competition. And m represents that there are 2^m teams in each group. So after discussing some ordinary routines for the football competition, we would like to find out the probability matrix of the FIFA World Cup. The format of it is similar to the improved elimination tournament with n equals to 5 and m equals to 2. The only difference is that there are specific routines for the knockout stage instead of having it randomly, and the routine is shown on the slide. So here is our result of the probability matrix of the FIFA World Cup. The reliability value of the FIFA World Cup is around 2.24, which is more than a half of the maximum reliability value of 4. And this can help us in investigating about choosing the correct tournament method again to gain the greatest profit in a competition. Besides, as we cannot judge which team has the absolute ranking, we also want to discuss about the teams, the cases that some teams are as strong as each other. So we said probability of winning will be 0.5 if two teams with same strength is meeting each other in a match. So here are two cases of the general case. So firstly, the case of team 1 is as strong as team 2, and team 2 and is as strong as team 3 is shown here. The probability matrix is just obtained by the single elimination tournament's probability matrix. And after some calculation, since the two teams have the same strength, we'll have the probability of 0.5 to win. The entries of the probability matrix should be the mean of the sum of the corresponding row in the probability matrix of single elimination tournaments we have shown before. And for the rigorous proof, it is stated in our report. So after obtaining this kind of probability matrix, we are going to investigate the profit of using them. So we define this formula, and the R is the reliability value defined before. The I is the standard constant, and C is the cost of holding a match, and the N is the number of matches needed to complete the event. So firstly, for the case of N equals to 4, which means that there are 16 teams in the competition, the profits of using different types of tournaments are shown here. And after some calculation, we obtain the two ranges below here. Similarly, for N equals to 5, the profits of using different kinds of tournaments will have the best profit is calculated also. But this time, we add a point that using the FIFA World Cup's form in order to compare them more accurately. And after some calculation, we find out the two ranges here below. And since we can see that the range of choosing method of World Cup can obtain the best profit is quite large, so it may be a reason that the FIFA will choose this kind of form to help the World Cup, that it can withstand a huge fluctuation of the cost due to some economical problem or inflections. To sum up, our report found out the general probability matrix of the three types of tournaments in the case of absolute ranking as well as some teams is same strong as each other. Besides, we can compare the profit of using different kinds of tournaments by using the probability matrix. On the other hand, we find out the probability matrix of the FIFA World Cup, and we understand why FIFA will choose such a special kind of tournaments for the World Cup rather than the free tournaments we have studied, as the range for obtaining the best profit using it is quite large. And so for the further discussion, we believe that our study can be extended to the case that the winning property will not only just won 0.5 or 0. This may be possible by using different actions of the probability matrix, such as the linear combination of them or just using other techniques. Also, the formula of the profit could be more accurate if more factors are concerned as well. So this is the end of my presentation. Thank you.